Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another battle report. This time it's my premier game with my Undying Dynasties, my Terracotta army, and I'm facing off against a Warriors of the Dark Gods army, 4,500 points. These are the lists. You can pause if you want to look at them. I will also put them down in the show notes below, but I won't go into any details here. The scenario that we were playing is Breakthrough, and we're deploying using Dawn Assault. And here we can see the deployment. My opponent deployed first to get a first turn. So he has two units of flayers, one on either flank. He has some barbarian horsemen, a chosen lord on Chimera, warriors of greed with a sorcerer, Forsorn with a doom lord, a sorcerer on Chariot, and Feldrax. And I, in return, brought my Terracotta army, as I said, for the first time, in their premier game. And I have some Shaptis. I have a bunker archers with the two Hierarch. One of them is a master of cosmology, the other an adept in evocation. I have my Necropolis guard, with an architect and a pharaoh, and a unit of chariots, also with an architect, and a unit of scouts. So, going into this battle, what is noticeable is that we are both very close combat focused armies. And he has four threats, with the Chosen Lord, the Warriors, the Forsorn, and the Feldrax. I only have three. And he also has more shaft than I do, with two player units and the Barbarian Horsemen. I only have the Scouts. So hopefully this should mean that my threats are mightier than his, and they probably are. So a bit of a cagey match, but should be interesting. Let's get into it. This is after his first movement phase, and he moved forward aggressively with the flayers and pretty aggressively with the rest of the army. And this is the other flank, as you can see. Magic saw him casting Hellfire on my Shaptis, and it cost two wounds. And he then suffered amnesia from a miscast and forgot the spell, so that was a big big bonus for me. Good start there. And in my turn, I decided to charge my scouts into his players, thinking that if I can get some buff spells through, this should be a favorable combat to me. Otherwise, it probably isn't. And I moved up to counter him a little bit, more so on the left flank with the chariots. And spells, I tried to get a buff through, but unfortunately I miscalculated and some of them were out of range. And I dispelled what I tried to do, and instead I got through an Ice of Fire on his player unit on the right flank and caused four wounds, and the last one panicked. So that was very, very nice, getting rid of a shaft unit, and a bit lucky on my part. But even more lucky was the combat, because even though he had like 15 attacks, 10 of them with strength 4, he only did one health point to me. And I, in return, with 7 attacks, caused 4 wounds on him. So he broke and ran off the table. And I even passed my discipline test to reform. Maybe be able to get back in the rest of the battle sometime soon. Unfortunately, I made a mistake in movement, and I allowed his Feldrax to easily move into my flank of the Shaptis, meaning I had to deal with them some way. And he advanced a little bit more with the rest of the army. In my turn, I also used my shooting to do 2 wounds to his barbarian horsemen. So my turn again, I rotated the Shaptis and backed up a little bit. Moved up the Necropolis Guard and the chariots a little bit as well. And had another good magic phase. I managed to get an ice and fire through and obliterated the barbarian horseman unit that was on his right flank, or in, yeah, on his right, my left. So that was very, very nice. He had 6 health points left, and I even did 7 wounds to him after saves. Very, very lucky. And that meant he was now out of chef, which puts the battle in a pretty strange position, because now it's just two close combat armies going to town on each other. No chef at all, because mine is far away and can't march, and his is obliterated. So it's just a matter of who gets the charges and gets the favorable combat that's gonna determine who wins. We're in for a spicy game after this. I also cast Ancestral Aids on my Shaptis and Unit Indiversion on this unit, which I had to do because I forgot to cast to put the Fortitude marker from one of the architects on this unit. I need to remember to always think about that at the start of my turn. But I had a good magic phase. This is what it looked like going in his turn. And his charges were the Felrax into my Shaptis, the Felrax, the Forsworn, and the Chosen Lord as well, and the warriors into the Necropolis Guard. And his thinking was that the Felrax were out to in, and he needed fairly high numbers on the other three charges. The warriors, I think, need an 8, maybe a 9 or 10 on the Chosen Lord, and similar on the Forsworn. But his thinking was that if he gets a few of these through, he's gonna be in a pretty good spot. A bit of a tricky situation. And he managed to succeed a charge with only the Chosen Lord and the Felrax, so the other two failed their charge. Which was pretty good for me, it looked like. So the combat that we got was this one. He managed to cast Word of Iron on his guys, so they had a pretty good save, even against my strength. 6 AP 3. So he still got a 5 up save against that, which did help him a lot. But I struck before the Felrax and killed 2 of them, and he only killed 2 of mine in total. I think we drew the combat, which was good because that meant his Chosen Lord didn't get the strength bonus from greed. Pretty rough combat, but it's going my way so far because his Felrak unit is melting faster than my Shaptis. And we're gonna focus in on this combat now. In my turn, I cast Perception of Strength on them instead of Ancestral Aid, and I killed an additional 2 Felraks, he didn't do much to me at all, really. But he didn't break, and I reformed to get more attacks on him. And in his turn, he charged the chariot into the unit. We'll be going through the rest of the battle after this. I'm just gonna run through what happens on this side of the table. So he got the chariot into unit, and I focused a lot of my attacks on the last Feldrak to kill it, and did that, as you can see here. But he started to really go to town on my unit with the Chosen Lord by now. And in my turn later then, he obliterated the unit, and I had not been able to get any support in. So he killed the unit and reformed to face my bunker, charged the bunker, And the Chosen Lord did what a Chosen Lord does, and killed a lot of dudes, and the unit broke, and he charged the scout unit as well and killed that too, towards the end of the game. Meanwhile, go back to this picture, or this stage in the battle. This was after his big charge, and our first turn of combat with the Shaptis. Or actually, this is just after the charge, but we'll talk on, through it from this picture. Now I had a choice to make here. The chariots could charge the warriors in the flank, and that was a very good combat for me. We figured that I should win that pretty much any day of the week. And I could put the Necropolis Guard and easy charge into the front and just to completely obliterate the unit. I don't think I saw the Felrax, or it just didn't occur to me, but I don't think I saw them. I had positioned myself badly in that regard, so I couldn't charge them. But I could charge the Force Orn, and I needed a 6 on the dice. And I decided to be greedy, and I charged the chariots into the flank of the warriors, and the Necropolis Guard into the front of the Force Orn. My plan was to put Truth of Time on the chariots to make them have a very good chance of overrunning into the flank of the Force Orn. They needed an 11, but with 5 dice, picking the 2 highest, that's not at all impossible. So that was my plan. But I failed with the Necropolis Guard charge. So they were stranded in the middle of nowhere. The chariots made it in though, and despite some unlucky rolls, I still won the combat by 7, so we had to stick on a discipline 2. And he rolled 3 on the dice, both the first time and the second time on the reroll. So that was funny. But it did break, and I had cast Truth of Time on myself still, for some reason. That was actually pretty stupid of me. And I did roll the 11, so I got into the flank of the Force Orn, which looked like this. And this, as it turned out, was not a good position to be in, because the chariots don't do a lot against the Force Orn, and my Necropolis Guard are completely stranded here. They can't do anything. They're locked in by the chariots. So in that, I ended up in a grind fest between these two, and his while the Force Orn didn't do much against the chariots, the Doom Lord did. And he started to go through the unit bit by bit. They melted away. Here you can see the chariot that charged into the Shaptis before he charged. And this is after the charge. And I also reform my move my Necropolis Guard here to be able to assist the chariots eventually, but it's taking a long time, unfortunately. And the combat continues to grind, and my chariots dwindle and dwindle, and eventually they are gone, and he reforms. And that's before I was able to charge. But this, he killed my charge unit in his turn, so my turn comes around, and I charge him, get perception strength on my unit, and I melt through him pretty quickly. The Pharaoh does alright against the Doom Lord, despite Godslayer not working, because he doesn't have an Aegis save. But this is closing in at the end of the game, and at the end of the game, we both had 1 health point left, I think. Pharaoh and the Doom Lord, but his unit was gone. And that's the end of the game, really. So during this combat, the Shaptis were melting away, and he killed the bunker and all of that. But yeah, that's pretty much it. So all that's left, really, is on his side the Doom Lord, but I get half points for that, the Chosen Lord, and the Chariot Wizard. And on my side, all that's left is my big Death Star, the Necropolis Guard, with 2 characters in. And when we all add all that up, I got 3,040 victory points, and he got 3,067. So he won by a mere 27 points. Neither of us got the objective, so the result was a 10-10. A very, very funny game, very bloody. There was, as I said, not a lot left. A good premier match for my Terracotta, I'd say. I was very lucky early on in the game with getting rid of his chaff, and I didn't really manage to capitalize on that. I misjudged how well my Shaptis would handle his Feldrax. The Feldrax themselves were pretty decent. We can talk from this picture. And I did go through them, but I should have focused more on the Chosen Lord. If I had, I might have been able to kill him, actually. Especially when the turn when I had Perception of Strength on the unit. The two turns, rather. And I did some mistakes with alignment here. I should have made sure that I could countercharge with the Necropolis Guard. But the big mistake really was my charges against his units in this situation here. What I should have done is I should have sent both units into the warriors, just made sure that I obliterate them, and then reform the Necropolis Guard to face the Forestorn and kill them, because they are not a problem for the Necropolis Guard. And then the Shoryas could just have kept on moving forward and getting to the deployment zone, just stay there. Because the Shaptis were taking care of the Feldrax, and then it wouldn't have any scoring units left, so I could have easily grabbed the objective doing that. And instead I got greedy and tried to charge both units and do a grand overrun, double combat fighting thing, and it failed. And then I didn't realize it soon enough. I should never have cast Truth of Time on my Chariots. I should maybe have cast it on his unit instead to make sure that I could overrun him and kill him. And hoped that I didn't roll an 11 to get into the flank of the Forsorn. That way, could still turn out the same way with my Necropolis Guard taking care of the Forsworn and the Shoryas being safe to move into the deployment zone. But yeah, I was really excited to cast that Truth of Time, so that was a mistake. But overall, it was a really, really fun game, and I'm looking forward to playing more with my Terracotta army, and hopefully you will see some more battle reports of that. So with that said, all that's left is to thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you on the next one. But that's actually a lie. I should talk a little bit about the format here, because I've changed it up a little bit for this battle report, getting back into it. I'm doing more of a narrative style of reporting the game. Instead of going through turn by turn, I feel that it's much more intuitive to focus on the small parts. When things get into the thick of it, at least, when you start to get the combats, you can focus on those combats bit by bit and scale up. You take the smaller combats, less important combats, and then you move up to the more important combats across the board. Tell the story that way. I find it more compelling. It's more natural to tell it that way. Like if you're just speaking to a friend about a battle you had, that's the way you're going to tell it. So I find it that more enjoyable, both to do and for me at least to listen to. So that's probably how I will do my battle reports in the future. And I would love to hear your thoughts on that. What you think of that style of reporting. So please put that down in the comments. I would really appreciate it. And with that, I thank you very much for listening and watching this. And I will see you on the next one. Cheers.